Cold spheres are great, since unlike UV spheres, they don't have any triangular faces. Rather, instead, they're made completely of just square faces, which is great for maintaining good topology. Today, I'll show you how to add them quickly and how to make them manually as well. The quickest way to add one is using an add-on built into Blender. So to enable this, all you need to do is left-click Edit, then left-click Preferences, and if I left-click this Add-ons button here, and then left-click Search Bar, then search for Extra, and then an option called Extra Objects will appear. You can enable both of these if you like, but the main one we need is the Add Mesh Extra Objects. Then once you've left clicked the box to enable it, you can left click these three bars and choose Save Preferences. Now to add our quad sphere, all we need to do is press Shift A, then under Mesh, there's an option called Round Cube, and if I left click this, you can see a beveled cube has been added to our scene. And the important option here is this option here at the bottom left hand corner. Keep in mind, if you click away from this object, this menu will disappear, so I can just open this up, and here I can adjust my radius to make it more spherical. So if I put it to 1, for example, now you can see we've got our perfect sphere. Then of course, if you want to make it a bit nicer, you can add a subdivision modifier by just pressing Ctrl 1 with the object selected. Now you can see that's looking a bit smoother. And of course, you can right click and choose Shade Smooth. This add-on also comes with a handy feature to adjust our cube at a later point. So if I wanted to turn it back into that beveled cube, for example, I could right click and press this Change Round Cube button. And now it will unshade smooth for us, but we can always adjust that later. I could then change my radius to something like 0.1. You can see we've got a beveled cube again. So a very flexible and useful add-on to have. Plus, it's free and built into Blender, so why not enable it? Now I'm going to press X and delete to delete my sphere, and this time I'm going to press Shift A, and then I'm going to choose Cube. And this time I'm going to show you how to create this sphere manually. First thing I'll do is press Control and then 2, and that's going to add a subdivision modifier of 2. And you can see already we've got a kind of sphere, but it's a little bit cubish, so we need to do a few things. First, I'll left click this blue spanner here, which is our modifier properties menu, and if I want to apply this modifier, because right now if I press Tab to go into edit mode, you can see we've still got a cube here. And to fix that, all we need to do is left click this arrow and choose Apply. Now when I press Tab to go into edit mode, you can see these faces have been applied and this change is now permanent. The reason I've done that is in order to make this more spherical, I need to edit the actual vertices of this geometry. What I'll do is in edit mode, which you can press Tab to go into, you can also choose it from up in this menu here, and then I'm going to press A, which will allow me to select all, and then I'm going to choose Mesh, Transform, and then left click this Two Sphere command. Then you can type in the number 1, and that's going to use that command to the full effect. If you want to adjust it after pressing enter, you can open this menu in the bottom left hand corner to adjust the factor. See, I can turn it back down to 0 so it's how it was before, and then if I turn it back to 1, we've got a nice spherical shape. Again, to make this smoother, I might want to add another modifier by just pressing Ctrl 1. That's going to add another subdiv modifier, and then I can right click and choose Shade Smooth. If you want to learn more about how this subdivision surface modifier works, I recommend checking out this video I made here. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care!